You are watching CIO TV by Enterprise IT World, a production of Accent Infomedia.
Having a clear vision is number one, and having a right team with the right people is number two.
So welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to CIOTV.live. I have a special guest with me. His name is Mr. Chandrasekhar R. He is the CTO IO, who is responsible for Matrimony.com's technology from a perspective of being CTO and information officer. He is the senior technology executive with over 29 years of experience. He is responsible for establishing technology roadmap related decisions, works closely with other departments, heads such as department heads such as sales, operation, marketing, finance, as an advisor to technologies to improve matrimony.com's efficiency and effectiveness. Also, he is responsible for ensuring overall customer experience in terms of uptime, performance, and taking care of internal analytics requirements. With this, I would like to welcome Mr. Chandrasekhar to CIOTV.live.
Thank you, Sanjay, for that introduction. And thanks to Enterprise IT World for the opportunity. I will share my views and like an overall matrimony, like as far as COVID is concerned, where matrimony is.
All right. So matrimony.com being an online and e-commerce company, what has been your experience so far in last 4-5 months amid COVID-19, where situation is not good, conducive for most of the companies?
As you rightly pointed out, being an online company, what we saw initially, we saw a positive effect. We saw an increase in the number of registration up to 30%. And young professionals who are working from home find more personal time. And since they don't have to commute to work and they can't go out for socializing. And as far as metrics is concerned, like it is more or less all days we see a steady traffic. As far as internal is concerned, prior to lockdown, the work from home was never an option. Now, most of our associates are working from home today.
All right. I came to know from the company press release that you have adopted certain bot service or chatbot, I can say. So what is the, my question is, what is the kind of enterprise strategy have you adopted seeing the COVID-19 situation? Was it, is it something that you developed seeing the onset of COVID-19, or you had certain plan earlier also?
Just before the lockdown, we formed a cross-functional team to look at the business continuity plan. We had a mobile app. However, we did it. We asked the team to further refine it to so that all our associates can use it to service our customer. The application was ready just before the lockdown, and we rolled it out to all our associates. Apart from it, what we carried out was we tested all our applications, the application which are posted in the cloud, in the VPN environment to avoid any surprise. And infra side wise, what we have done is we increased the bandwidth and is also procured more laptop and tablets. By this kind of approach, almost all associates were able to service our customer immediately after the lockdown.
Mr. Chandrasekhar, you are being in a new age company. I expect you do not have your infra or your data center on premise. This is the trend that you definitely host from any sort of cloud. If it is, if I'm saying the right thing, are you hosted on cloud? Are you adapted to cloud situation, cloud computing? If yes, if you can shed some light on that.
Yes. We hosted All our applications are hosted in a hybrid cloud. We have a private cloud and we use the public cloud to handle the any surge in the traffic or any new business requirement. And we also use the public cloud for the DR purpose. Apart from the main data center, what we have in Mumbai, what I mentioned, we do have a data center in Chennai to handle our big data as well as analytics requirement. Apart from it, we use the content distribution network of a leading service provider to serve the content to our end users.
So, you spoke about work from home. That is obvious. So, what percentage of your workers is it 100% IT workers that are from work from home environment, or some are on prem also coming to your office? If 100%, even though not 100%, there has been big challenges, prior to this. Now it is continuing from the cybersecurity. Ransomware is everywhere in the news. Bandwidth, you said, bandwidth has been a very big challenge till now. No organization is immune from bandwidth challenges. So two things. One is the security, and then another is bandwidth. You look to be very cool. When I speak to you now, you look to be very cool. How have you managed the security aspect, the bandwidth aspect for the work from home environment? And what percentage of employees are from work from home scenario?
To begin with, almost 100%, almost all employees were working from first 21 days, all the employees were working from home.
Okay.
Now, as we speak, if you look at 80% of our assets are working from home. Balance 20%, we made it as optional. Whoever wants to come to work, they can come and work in the office. That's the kind of environment what we have today. And what we do, as I told you, just before the lockdown, we increased the overall bandwidth as far as our branch, across all branches. Second thing is, as we speak, what we are doing is, we are looking at giving a broadband connection. Last 4 or 5 months, people were managing with the mobile dongles. Now we are looking at giving a broadband to all our associates, all deserved associates. We are looking at broadband so that in the near future also, they will be able to continue to work from home without any disturbance on the bandwidth. Okay. What we have one, all of our, we enabled access to our application through the VPN. From the security point of view, what we ensure is that all the latest stable patches gets applied to the all networking devices what we have. Apart from it, the antivirus patch, anti-malware patches to avoid any ransomware attack, make sure that all latest patches gets applied into the all endpoints. We have done a regular network penetration test on regular basis. And more than anything else, what we have done is, we have launched an enterprise-wide campaign about the security do's and don'ts for all our associates to avoid phishing attack, to overcome the phishing attack related challenges.
All right. Now, is there any project that you are working on? If at all you are planning to do certain projects? My question is related to this, that these days the management or the CFOs are saying that you need to do more with the less. It means they are contracting the budget, saying that the budget which was allocated to you for this quarter, next quarter. So both the budgets are contracted and you have to manage with that budget for the entire year. Are you facing that kind of challenge if at all you are looking at a new fresh project, even those ongoing projects also being impacted because of the contracted budget? Are you going through that situation?
Not really. In our case, it is. Since it's almost a business as usual, what we are doing, as I told you, the laptop and the tablet procurement, where we are procuring a huge laptops and tablet was not in the initial annual plan when we have worked on somewhere in February. But however, this request got approved, keeping the new normal in mind. So that way, there is no staggering of any spend from the IT point of view.
All right. Next one is, are you planning or do you have any RPA at the back end? Because you are a customer-centric organization. So bringing automation, bringing quick response to the market, bringing customer satisfaction are key to your organization, which the IT enables. You being the cornerstone, you strategize how to bring all this efficiency to the business process. So are you having any kind of automation or robotics process automation at the back end in the enterprise application level? At the front end, of course, you are saying that something like chatbot kind of things are getting integrated. So, and any plan for the future?
Yeah. Daily, for example, we have done few automation. We acquire around 25 to 30,000 customers. Okay. Almost all profiles, we validate all profiles as well as the photo on daily basis. Now we have automated this process by implementing AIML as well as a rule-based automation we have done. That's a major one. So that rather than doing this job rather than 100 people, we are able to, with the 20 to 30% of the resources, we are able to do it. That's number one. Number two, as you pointed out, we implement a chatbot to handle the customer queries. So that now certain amount of queries, now the chatbot itself is able to handle the customer queries. So these are some of the automation what we have implemented.
Nowadays, I'm seeing that in organization are also allowing, giving free hand to the IT leaders to implement or experiment with the blockchain for the automation or for the authentication particularly. So, and do you have that in your mind? Maybe not now. Going forward, everything goes fine.
Yeah, from the blockchain point of view, distribution of the data on that, we keep an eye on the latest technology development. As of now, we don't have any plan. Probably in the future, yes, if need arises, we may go for.
All right, I'll ask you the last question about your advice to the peer and advice to those CIOs or budding CIOs, you can say, or CTOs who are going to become technology leaders and decision makers, particularly being leader are not the decision makers necessarily, but tomorrow they are becoming a decision maker sitting in the board alongside the CEO and CFOs. What would be your piece of advice to them in terms of technology decision making or finance decision making, which impacts the overall business process? Because whatever you are doing, that is reflecting upon the business outcome.
Rather than the advice, I would say, from my own views in this one is, one, I would say that having a clear vision is, having a clear vision is number one. And having a right team with the right people is number two. Keeping an eye on the latest development in the industry. And the fourth one is by saying that we are networking with peer in the industry. I would consider these four as the key for success of any leader.
All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Chandrasekhar. Pleasure talking to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Sandeep.